Well, the president of Southern Maine Community College says while the campus is in a beautiful location, that location is causing some long waits in South Portland when it comes to traffic. The forecaster's David Harry takes a closer look. Well, David, first of all, thanks so much for joining us. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Tim. It's a pleasure to be here. It's nice to see you again.
You as well. Well, let's talk about, we're on the road here to SMCC. Why has this traffic become such an issue that they're going to have a community forum about it? Talk about how it's gotten to this point.
Well, basically, increased enrollment is the real reason. If you look back to about 2003, the school had about 3,500 students, I believe. And now it's about 7,500. Not all necessarily attending courses here, but certainly a great amount of people who have been coming here either because a two-year college fits well into a four-year strategy for high school students getting in, getting post secondary education, or because people are making a available job training and needing to switch careers because of a tough economy, things like that. Essentially, the community forum, which is 6:30 next week at the Culinary Arts School next Thursday, is going to be an effort to discuss some strategies on how they can alleviate some of the congestion that people are seeing on Broadway throughout the school day. There are, in all honesty, some limitations as to what can be done. Dr. Cantor has said that they are looking at alternative scheduling of classes to help relieve some of the traffic flow. There's been a successful program allowing free bus transportation for students that he says is taking about 220 cars a day out of parking lots, and also working to have parking spaces for people who carpool, things like that. But Broadway is still a two-lane road going back and forth, coming down to a peninsula, and with a school that's had a marked increase in enrollment. They're also hoping that expanding the Brunswick campus will allow people to take courses in other locations along with online courses.
And now finally, down a little further down on Broadway, at one of the intersections, there is a blinking light.
There is.
Could there be a possibility to turn that maybe to a traffic light?
Well, it's certainly been looked at, but as Tex Heuser had noted, Maine Department of Transportation sort of governs, if you will, installation of traffic lights, and using a set of data and measurements that are require looking at both streets. And while certainly Broadway easily qualifies for the idea of putting a full light where that blinking signal is, traffic on Sawyer Street apparently doesn't quite measure up to it. It's not necessarily what you want to hear if you're someone trying to make a right turn or a left turn coming out of Ferry Village and or the Willard Square area, but it's just a case of how they look at things.